over 60% of adults, and I think it's even over 65% of adults, have one form or another of periodontal disease, and it will shorten your life. Hi, I'm Dr. Joe Nemeth, a periodontist in Southfield, Michigan, and I want to welcome my friend and excellent periodontist, Dr. Tom McCawley. We've known each other for what seems like forever. We've done much training together, and we are honored to have him join us today.
I'm honored to be with Dr. Nemeth, one of the top periodontists in the world. It's a gift to me to have his friendship.
Today we're going to talk about periodontal pockets. What is a periodontal pocket? And maybe get into periodontal disease and how these periodontal pockets relate to periodontal disease.
A periodontal pocket is really the result of periodontal infection. And so we measure it with a little probe, and once it gets over about 4 or 5 millimeters, we know that it's just like a pocket on my jacket here. You have lint down at the bottom. You can't get that out, just like bacteria. So all your brushing and flossing, still the bacteria is down there. So Dr. Nemeth and I have really had the first laser in the country that would allow us to get down here and get that lint, the bacteria, out of the pocket. We started in 1990, and we've done more of these cases than anybody in the world.
This is a case where Lanap was done, and not only did it stop the infection, but we were able to get bone to fill in between the roots and in front of the tooth, so the tooth now is going to survive where it would not have survived otherwise.
We talked about pockets before. The gum is here, but when we put the probe in here, the pocket goes all the way down here. So there's an infection down deep in that pocket. And now, here is almost no pocket. Now you can clean this.
Periodontal disease, gum disease, which is what we treat with Lanap, is the other silent killer. They talk about high blood pressure as being a silent killer. Gum disease is also a silent killer. If you have gum disease, you may live 6 to 7 years less than if you don't have gum disease. It affects every organ in your body negatively. It's incredibly important to get rid of this infection, and the laser will do that. These bacteria get into your bloodstream and travel throughout the body. Well, your body can fight these bacteria off, but it can't fight it off as long as it's keeping fed in by the bacteria in your mouth. So if we can stop the gum disease, we can stop the bacteria from getting into the body, and then the body has a chance to fight off and destroy these organisms.
That's brilliant, and that's a key issue, how gum disease affects your health. This result also kills all the bacteria, like we talked about, and we've proven that you can kill the bacteria with the laser. No other procedure ever has been shown to do that. We actually proved that. The old treatment was cutting and stitching, where you'd have a lot of pain, and you rarely would get a result like this.
Let's talk about one of your cases.
This tooth actually had pockets that went all the way to the end of the root. It was 11 millimeters, the pocket, all right? So we treated it with Lanap, we grew the bone back, and the pocket was 3 millimeters. So instead of way deep in there, now we got the bone back and got rid of the pocket. And then here's another case. This was a 30-year-old lady, a dentist's daughter. He sent her over and they said it has to come out and get an implant. Well, the bone loss was beyond the apex, so we were able to treat that, grow the bone back, the tooth got tight again, so that was a pocket that went up here to 13 millimeters. That's about that long, all right? And now we got it back to like 3 or 4 millimeters.
So this is, to me, a very fascinating case. This gentleman came to me approximately 9 years ago. And at that time, he just didn't feel either financially or emotionally ready to proceed with treatment. He had enough bone where if we treated him, we would have been able to save these teeth with Lanap, but he neglected to have anything done. So he came back 9 years later, and 9 years later, you can see almost all of the bone that was there is no longer there. The bone has been almost completely destroyed, and now there's nothing that I can do for him. There is something that Dr. Katranji can do for him. He can do implants. So his only choice is really either just getting the teeth out and maybe some dentures, which in my opinion suck, or he can have implants.
Over time, if the infection's not treated, the bone just keeps going. You get deeper and deeper and deeper pockets. The teeth get loose and you end up needing implants. We always prefer the teeth. A tooth is way better than an implant because implants actually get more infection than teeth.
If a gum pocket is over, let's call it 4 millimeters, it's very likely to be infected, and this can be measured by your general dentist, or it can be measured by a periodontist or a hygienist. If it goes untreated, it can continue to destroy bone and cause tooth loss.
Also, oftentimes, once you get to about 4, you'll get bleeding. So many times people think bleeding gums are normal. They're not normal. Every time you have bleeding, it's an infection causing the bleeding. It's ulcerating the tissue in the pocket. So that's why bleeding can indicate to you pockets, and also bad breath sometimes will come from that.
Some of the new toothpastes, especially those that have stannous fluoride, will actually kill some of the superficial bacteria that contribute to bleeding. So we're getting less patients with bleeding, but not less patients with periodontal disease, because the toothpaste, the stannous fluoride or other fluoride toothpaste, which may control the superficial bacteria that cause superficial bleeding, do not get deep into the pocket and eliminate the disease-causing bacteria. So it's not just bleeding. If you notice your teeth shifting, if the teeth are getting loose, any kind of discomfort, if your bite is changing, all of these are factors that can indicate periodontal disease. So if you notice any of the things that we've talked about, if you have any concerns, because periodontal disease is so prominent that over 60% of adults, and I think it's even over 65% of adults, have one form or another of periodontal disease, and it will shorten your life. So it's important to get attention to that, and it doesn't cause pain. So make sure you get checked regularly, and if you notice anything going on, especially make sure you get checked, and perhaps by a periodontist.
Also, you can assume, if you're over 50, that you have gum disease. It's probably at least 50% of the people will have it. So assume that you have it until proven wrong and get it treated early.
Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for being here, Dr. McCawley. At any rate, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Questions, comments, we'd love to hear from you. And remember, if your mouth is not healthy, you simply can't be as healthy as you could otherwise be. And as I always say, most importantly, have a good day.
Restore your smile and your health. Visit drnemeth.com to schedule your appointment today.